Hey, this is Colin, and in this video, I'm going to give you a quick walkthrough of Visual Electric. So after you log in, you'll be taken to the Inspiration Gallery. The gallery is a collection of images that were generated by members of our community. If you hover over an image, you can see the prompt and the style that was used to create it. If you click on an image, it will open up large in a light box. At the top of the gallery are our filters. These are the same categories that we use to organize the styles in our product. In the top left corner is your workspace switcher. By default, everybody is given a personal workspace that's private to just you. But if you want to create a shared workspace with your team, you can do that here. Below that is the navigation. You have canvases. You have your profile, which is a public profile where you can share images that you've generated. And what's new is a list of updates to the product, including new styles and features. In the bottom left-hand corner is your profile menu. You can contact support, manage your billing information if you've upgraded to a paid account, or log out. If you want to create a new canvas, you can click on the New Canvas button in the top right corner. Or you can go to the Inspiration Gallery and click on the Remix button on any image. This will create a new canvas and place that image on the canvas. To go back, just click on the Back button in the top left corner. And you can see the canvas that you just created here. To open it, just click on it. If you've never used an infinite canvas before, there's two concepts that you should know about. The first is zooming. If you're on a laptop, you can zoom by just pinching in and out on a trackpad. You can also use the zoom menu in the top right corner, and there's keyboard shortcuts for all of these actions. My preferred way to zoom is to use a keyboard and mouse. So if you're on a Mac, you can hold Command, or if you're on a PC, you can hold Control, and then you can zoom in and out using your scroll wheel. Notice that you will zoom to wherever your cursor is. So this is an easy way to target exactly where you want to go. The second concept is panning. Panning allows you to click and drag to move the canvas around. To pan, you can click on the hand tool and then click and drag. Or with the pointer tool selected, you can hold the space bar on your keyboard. That will put you in the hand tool temporarily, which lets you click and drag. And then when you release the space bar, you'll be taken back to the pointer tool. On the top, you have your tools, Composer, which lets you create images, and then you have your right sidebar, which is contextual to whatever you have selected. There's Properties, Tools, and Actions. Because I have an image selected, I'm seeing the image properties here, as well as the prompt that was used to create this image. These tools are AI tools that let me edit the image, and actions are things like download or share. On the left-hand side, you have the Inspiration Gallery. This is the same gallery that we were looking at before. You also have a Layers palette where you can see every element on your canvas in the order that it's in. To create an image, just click into the Composer and type a prompt. You'll notice that after you start typing, the composer will offer suggestions. These suggestions are from a model that we've trained on what we understand to be a good prompt. A good prompt will include a subject and a location. So if you typed in a subject, it will offer you a location and vice versa. So this is a basic good prompt, but I'm going to add a little bit of style information as well. At the bottom are some additional controls that you can use to guide the model. You can define a color palette for your image. You can exclude certain words from your image. So this is telling the model what you don't want to include. And you can pick a style for your image. I'm going to pick black and white. By default, images will generate in portrait, but you can also choose any other aspect ratio. The Generate button has two modes. By default, images will be generated with the highest quality, but you can also choose the fastest speed. This will generate images about 2.5 times faster, but it will do so at a lower quality. So once your images have generated, if you like what you've created, you can scroll down and click the download button. Or if you want to change your prompt, you can go back up to the composer, click on it, and edit the prompt. You can also use the Art Director tool. This allows you to describe the change that you'd like to see, and we'll automatically rewrite the prompt for you. So that's the basics of Visual Electric. If you have any other questions, reach out by email or contact us on Twitter or Instagram.